Hi, I am Dr. Saqib Mansoor, and today I will discuss with you branches of anatomy, the very, very important science of medicine, anatomy. So first I will enumerate the branches, then I will define each of them, right? So the learning objectives are define different branches of anatomy. So let's define first human anatomy, what it is. Definition is, human anatomy is the science which deals with the structure of the human body. So it deals with structure. So the branches, so many of them. Branches of anatomy. Cadaveric anatomy, the living anatomy, gross anatomy, general anatomy, regional anatomy, or the topographic anatomy, the special anatomy, and the surface anatomy, and the cross-sectional anatomy. I am enumerating this just giving you a list, then I will discuss each of them briefly, their definition. Radiological anatomy, the developmental anatomy, number A of these developmental is embryology, and B is fetology, A and B collectively called as prenatal development. Teratology, comparative embryology, experimental embryology, statistical anatomy. Next, anthropology, physical anthropology, racial anatomy, surgical anatomy, applied or the clinical anatomy, histology of the microscopic anatomy, and the cytology. Next is the comparative anatomy, the functional anatomy, ultrastructural anatomy, morphology, ontogeny, phylogeny. And this is the last slide for branches, the systemic anatomy, dealing with the system. This is osteology, arthrology, myology, that also includes locomotor apparatus, angiology, neuroanatomy, splanchnology. This is the study of the visceral system except cardiovascular and lymphatic system. Systems include respiratory system, digestive system, urinary system, genital and endocrine systems, right? So let's definitions of branches of anatomy, the discussion. So first of all is the cadaveric anatomy, right? Obviously, it is a traditional and essential method for learning anatomy. It is studied on dead, preserved, or embalmed bodies, commonly with the naked eye. This is also called as macroscopic or gross anatomy. Here you could see this is a section of the neck and part of the face of the cadaver, right? Here you could see we learn anatomy from that traditionally, right? So second branch is the living anatomy. It is studied by inspection, palpation, percussion, auscultation, and the radiography. Here you could see this is the parts of the, this is the upper limb, and this is the shoulder region, right? This is the chest. And here we can do the inspection and even the palpation. Over the chest, we do the heart auscultation. And we can take the radiography. We will show a radiograph to you very soon. And the third branch is embryology. This is also known as the developmental anatomy. It's a study of the prenatal developmental changes in an individual. Developmental anatomy is number A, embryology, and number B is fetology. A and B are termed prenatal development. I also told you before. Teratology, this is abnormal development of organisms, right? So comparative embryology pertains to study of the similarities and differences in embryos of different species, right? And the experimental embryology studies how an organism grows from one single cell to adult form, right? So branches continue, the definitions. Histology, or the microscopic anatomy, is a study of the structures with the help of a microscope. Here you could see this is the microscope, right? And this is a simple microscope, right? And we put the slide over here and study with this lens. Number five is cytology, deals with the structure, function, and pathology of cells, right? This is a part of the cell. This is mitochondria. And such structures are seen in the branch of cytology. Difference: cytology is study of the cells, while histology is the study of the tissues. Next slide, surface anatomy or the topographic anatomy. This is the study of the deeper parts of the body with respect to skin surface, right? It's very important indeed, at times gets extremely important. It is helpful in surgical operations and clinical practice. Here you could see the example carotid pulse. This is the carotid artery and the physician is palpating that. Many pulses, right? The radial pulse is very important. But our focus right now is at the carotid pulse. So branches of anatomy continue. Radiographic and imaging anatomy, study of the bones and deeper structures by use of the plain and contrast radiography, ultrasound, and the CT or the computerized tomographic scans. Here you could see, this is the lateral radiograph of the skull. Here you could see this. This is the various structures, right? Then is the comparative anatomy. This is the study of the anatomy of other animals to explain changes in form, structure, and function. This is morphology of the various parts of the human body. Next branch is the functional anatomy. It discusses how organ systems function. Number 10 is the ultrastructural anatomy. It pertains to the fine, detailed biological structures seen at high magnifications characteristically by use of methods like electron microscopy. Next is the anthropology. This is the science of human beings. And number 12 is the physical anthropology. It pertains to the external features and measurements of diverse races and groups of people and with study of the prehistoric remains. Here you could see, this is a physical anthropology, right? This is showing the development of from this posture, whatever this you call it, right? Yeah, this is the Darwin's theory, and this is ultimately evolution of the human being. So the branches of anatomy continue. The applied anatomy or the clinical anatomy pertains to application of anatomical knowledge to the medical and the surgical practice. Here you could see, this is a picture, and you see three nerves are related to this bone, humerus. This is the axillary and radial, and this is the ulnar. These three all are related to the back of the humerus, or the posterior side. Then is the experimental anatomy, pertains to the factors which influence and determine the form, structure, and the function of different parts of the body. Next is the genetics. It deals with the study of information that is present in the chromosomes. You know, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes in humans. The general anatomy, next branch, it pertains to the fundamental anatomical principles that relate to a various organisms, including humans. Number 17, the regional anatomy, is also called as the topographic anatomy, study of the structure of the body by region, by study structures in the head, abdomen, arm, etc. Approach used in most medical and dental colleges or schools. So the systemic anatomy, osteology, this branch of anatomy deals with the bones. Arthrology is the knowledge of joints. Myology is the study of the structure, arrangement, and action of muscles. And geology, what is that? This is the study of the blood vessels and the lymph vessels. Neuroanatomy, study of the structure and organization of the nervous system. Splanchnology, right? Very interesting. The study of the visceral systems, except cardiovascular and lymphatic system. Systems include, I've already told you, digestive system, urinary system, respiratory system, endocrine system, and the genital system. Then is the special anatomy, the specialized study of the structure of the definitive organs, regions, or systems of the body going beyond the general overview of the anatomy. Next is the cross-sectional anatomy, a transverse cut through a structural tissue, right? So this is at right angle to the longitudinal section. Statistical anatomy, right? It involves the statistics. Racial anatomy, study of anatomical differences between the racial groups, right? So all the races have different anatomical features which is distinct to them. Then this is the last slide, of the today's topic, the morphology, the study of the form and structure of the organisms and their parts, including external and internal features. Then is in the last, I will discuss ontogeny and phylogeny. What is the difference between them? Ontogeny is a process of individual development from a single cell, an egg cell or zygote, to a complete adult organism, right? This is ontogeny. So what is phylogeny? Evolutionary history and the relationships among the groups of organisms. So thank you very much for watching my video. So very soon I will complete all the branches of all the topics of the general anatomy. So please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much and goodbye.